Well, Aussie comedian Josh Thomas has come a long way since winning the Raw Comedy Competition aged just 17. He's also come out.
What an incredible Sunday. Isn't it just mind-blowing to think we actually get to eat this?
Josh, I want to talk to you about something.
Oh. No. No. No, you don't.
I think we should break up.
Oh. Oh, that's bad.
I kind of feel like we've drifted, you know?
This isn't good at all.
Also, you're gay.
What? No. No, I'm not.
Josh, you're probably gay.
I'm not.
I mean, we could still be friends, if you like. It wouldn't be really that different, would it?
Is $19 Sunday suddenly pretty humiliating?
Oh. Well, Josh has made successful shows, Please Like Me and Everything's Gotta Be Okay. And today he's releasing a new podcast called How to Be Gay that explores exactly that. And he joins us now from Los Angeles. Good morning, Josh.
Hey.
Hey, mate, are you enjoying it over there?
In America? It's fine.
Yeah.
It's okay. Fine.
You're lying through your teeth.
How's it different to Australia?
Country. It's not. They're just sort of a bit, like, deranged all the time, you know? And they, like, But I've got, like, there's, like, six Americans that I really like. And I hang out with them mostly, and the rest of the time, I don't know. They like, I'm in LA as well, and in LA, people are really sort of fake, and they just lie to you, like, all the time, and I find it really confusing, because I'm autistic. I have, like, a hard enough time understanding people when they're, like, being, like, direct, and I just like it in Australia, because everybody's really, like, straightforward and funny.
Yeah, speaking of straightforward, let's talk about your new podcast. Mm. Where'd you get the idea of this from?
Yeah, because I'm gay.
Right.
Thought
that might have been how to maybe be a hint.
Yeah, it's called How to Be Gay, which obviously is not like a question you can answer, right? That title is supposed to be stupid. It's based on before I like worked out I was gay, I used to type all these really dumb questions into Google. Like once I Googled, am I gay? Which is like a very dumb thing to Google. Like if you're asking the question, first of all, you're probably gay. But also like that's not a question Google can answer. Like Google's really great at like giving you answers to things like what's a baby giraffes look like, but it's not a good place to go to look within. And this podcast is kind of me asking all those really dumb questions to like a range of like really cool, like interesting queer people and getting like a diverse range of experiences. Does that sounds gay, doesn't it?
But that's the point though, isn't it, Josh?
Exactly.
And you've also got some wonderful guests as well. You're joined by your mum at one point. How was that?
Yeah. You know, it was really, my mom, she's like me, she's like very blunt and she's very direct. And I had her on and I feel like probably that 2 minutes of her talking about what I'm like is like one of the most revealing things I've ever done. I had her in the episode, we have two episodes about having children and I don't want to have children because I would be terrible at it and because children are disgusting.
And we have kids and we agree.
Everyone always says to me... Everyone always says to me that when I grow up, they're like, but you see in your 30s, like sometimes people change in their 30s and like maybe you want to have kids in your 30s. I'm 35 now and I still don't. But my mom has always, like since I was 12, she said to me like, I don't think you don't want to be a dad. I don't think you'll ever be a dad. So I had her on the podcast to ask her why she said that because and why she's been saying that for 20 years. Because it's actually quite insulting, isn't it? Like if someone says to you, hey, you'd make a really great dad. That's like quite a sweet thing to hear. And my mom's just like, no.
Oh. I must say thank you because I did have a part in Please Like Me and I still get a residual.
Hi, Denise.
How are you?
I love still you. Get a residual? You know that. That's good but news. I'm so happy.
I still get a residual check every now and then for Please Like Me. So thank you.
Thank you. It's nice to see you.
It's good to see you. But listen, if you were able to listen to your podcast as a teenager, mm-hmm. would it have been helpful to you?
You know, I get a bit worried about people who look at me there with that cricket bat. What? I mean, that's okay. You don't need Google. I don't. I. You know, it, I. I I think that the podcast is not trying to answer anything. It's supposed to give you like a range of views. And I hope we've done a good job of like, if you were like a young queer person listening to this podcast, hearing all different kinds of options and different kind of lives that you can live. Is kind of what I'm hoping for. I honestly, I don't talk that much in the podcast. It's mostly me, like, listening, which now, is...
Can I ask you a question? Oh? When did your mum know that you were gay?
Well, you know, everyone thought I was gay when I was young, but then I did, like, years of stand-up comedy about how everyone thinks I'm gay, but I'm not. And then I had, like, a lot of girlfriends. Like, I was very stubborn about it. I really, like, held on to heterosexuality for a long time. And then... So by the time I came out, everyone had kind of... thought that I wasn't gay anymore, so then they were surprised again. But does that make sense, what I just said?
Because you grew up in Brisbane, and yeah, like to kind of keep yourself hidden for that long. That's
look, definitely out now, because the press release refers to you as a grown, fully qualified homosexual.
Yeah.
Is that something you find yourself saying a lot?
I'm really good at it now. I've made up for lost time. Do you know what I mean?
about
to tell you that I have a hickey, but then I got embarrassed.
Wait, hang on, did you say you have a hickey now?
Yeah.
Where?
I got my first ever hickey. But you can't see it. I put so much.
You mean love so much, bite, don't you? See, hickey's
a
love
bite. Love bite.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a love bite. I never had one before.
Josh, that's very schoolies of you. I like that. Yeah.
Does that
it's
mean
weird,
a new...
weird, isn't it?
Does that mean you've got a lovely new person that you're going out with?
Just a friend.
No, he's not going to say it. I don't mind. I don't mind.
Or anything. It's just a friend.
I just want you to be happy.
Hang on, we're friends and we don't give each other hickeys, do we, Denise?
Oh. I was hoping for one. No, the thing is, I just love you so much. I just want you to be happy. And I hope those LA
people... Oh, I love
people,
you too, Denise. I want you to be happy.
I just hope those LA people know what they've got in you. He's just brilliant.
Oh, such a superstar. And, Josh, I loved as well that last year you were really honest on your Instagram page and you shared that you are... autistic as well. How has that influenced your comedy, do you think? Has that kind of given you some insights into some of the funny things you do and say?
I mean, it hasn't influenced that much in my life. Probably it's influenced my life in a bad way, because now if I don't, like, reply to an email or do something promptly, or, like, if I insult someone by accident, I'm just like, I'm autistic. I just use that to get away with everything, which I don't think is what you're meant to do, and I wouldn't recommend that's what other people do. And I don't know. I mean, it was kind of interesting, because, like, you kind of think maybe that the diagnosis is this big revelation, but, like, everything... that autism is, I knew about myself already. It's just that it never had, like, a label. And then you guess, I mean, when you get a diagnosis like that, I've had two. First, I was diagnosed with ADHD, and then I was diagnosed with autism. And both times, it's, like, a big moment of, like, accepting kind of who you are, understanding where your shortcomings are, and, like, figuring out how to like yourself anyway, which I think is, like, kind of nice. And that's, like, I think why people get diagnosed, so they can... come to terms with that. Yeah. I mean, because it is like, they do sit you down, like they sit you down and they say, like, they like list your flaws and then they say it's uncurable. And then they charge you like $500. Like, I don't know if I needed this experience that much. But then I got a bit sad when the word uncurable was used. But then I think everybody, you know, has their flaws and they've got their things that aren't great about them. And probably everybody's not going to get that much better over their life, right?
No.
Like what's
We've
crappy
all got
about
a bit of uncurability.
Yeah. What's going to be...
The only thing that's uncurable about you is the fact that you're just a beautiful human being and adore you.
Yeah.
Are you still having those elderberry wine and vodka drinks?
That's how we got the hickey.
Your cocktails.
Of course. Next time I'm down, we'll have one.
Okay. Oh. It's all right. Dice. Love you.
Josh, thank you so much for your time. And you take care and absolutely slay them over there in LA.
Yeah, he would be.
Thank you.
Oh, and Josh, by the way, toothpaste on the hickey doesn't work. It's a myth. I've been dumb enough to try that in my youth. Yeah. Doesn't work.
It especially doesn't work when it's on somebody else's teeth.
All right, we've teased him enough. Poor Josh. Josh's new podcast, How to Be Gay, it's out today on Audible. Listen to it. He's a great bloke. Thanks again for joining us.
So
thanks,
cool.
Josh. Take care, mate.
Bye-bye, darling.
Bye.